Yeah, we begin in Sudan, where the international community led by the United States is working hard to ensure that South Sudan's January 9th secession vote runs smoothly. But significant challenges remain. VOA's Nico Colombant has the story.
The voting is supposed to be the culmination of a 2005 peace deal between Sudan's government and the Southern Sudan People's Liberation Movement, or SPLM, which ended two decades of fighting. There are supposed to be two referenda, one in the oil-rich Abyei border region and the other for the rest of South Sudan. Independent analysts say nearly all residents of Abyei want to join the South. But Sudan's ruling National Congress Party has already said it would not recognize any voting in Abyei. Nafi Ali Nafi is the NCP's deputy chairman.
The international community should not be greedy. Abyei should not be controlled by the South to please the Sudan People's Liberation Movement. No foreign power, not America, or anybody else behind the SPLM can force us to release Abyei to the South. Abyei will never be annexed to the South.
One major obstacle has been agreeing on a voter list for Abyei and whether to include pro-Sudan nomadic populations who regularly pass through the region.
In a state of war of independence.
The SPLM's U.S. representative, Ezekiel Lolgat-Kuot, says Sudan's government is holding the issue of Abyei hostage.
We are not moving forward, but the SPLM is committed to making sure that we have a breakthrough on Abyei, even if it means that we are going to pay a ransom. We are willing to do that so that the Ngok people of Abyei can decide their future freely.
To help find a solution for Abyei and for such issues as exact border demarcation, the United States and others have proposed a number of financial incentives. In addition, the U.S. has said it would remove Sudan from its list of state sponsors of terrorism. Zach Verton, a Sudan analyst with the International Crisis Group, says there are limits to such diplomatic agreements since they are not always approved by the U.S. Congress, which has final authority.
That these are ultimately limited, and I think the view in Washington and elsewhere outside of the country is different than it is in Khartoum. In some sense, these offers, these incentives do have limits. And the NCP feels in the past that the rug has been pulled out from under them when the U.S. came forward, and they're afraid that may happen again.
In Sudan and in other parts of Africa, officials and analysts have also expressed fears that the United States is pursuing a divide-and-rule strategy to break up a regional heavyweight often opposed to U.S. policies. John Prendergast from the Enough Project, a U.S.-based human rights activist group, rejects this view.
This is a process that's been led by the Southern Sudanese people. And I know my own motivations, and I think they mirror the United States, have been to support those people as they have suffered more than most, if not all, other Africans.
U.S. officials have said they believe a free and fair vote in southern Sudan is a key to lasting peace and prosperity for both the South and North. Southerners who go to the polls on January 9th are widely expected to vote overwhelmingly for the creation of a new African country. Nico Colombant, VOA News, Washington.